We started out about 20 years ago as a website, and the only aim that we had was to publish the articles that we had and trying to report about the scene that we loved so much and the bands that we liked. We had an idea to actually try and get the feel of the website on stage, and that was like the start of Roadburn Festival in a very small way.
Roadburn is something I think that transcends just being a typical music festival. For me as a listener of heavy music, of dark, somber music, it's one of the only places that some of the bands that exist within the sub genres of things are truly celebrated. You can see Mizmor play in front of almost 2,000 people. You can see, you know, Bellwitch play to almost 2,000 people, an entire album. You don't really get that experience at other music festivals. You just don't, due to a wide variety of limitations. And the fact that there are so many bands that are willing to take an extra step and put in the extra effort to play these unique sets also makes Roadburn a truly special place.
I've only missed 1 year in 8 years, and I feel like it's one of my biggest regrets.
The bands are doing all the time something very special. The atmosphere is special. It's people who are passionate by music.
This whole week I've been meeting people who come to Roadburn 7, 8, 9 years in a row, and it didn't take a really long time to figure out why. There's something really unique about the way they celebrate underground bands with a respect and attention that they find nowhere else in the world. And the bands reciprocate that by performing a set that the audience will never see anywhere else in the world.
He asked if Converge would play in 2016, I believe, and we put together two special sets for him. I stayed in touch with Walter and everybody that just were part of this, and they asked, hey, do you want to curate this year? It would be something that could be interesting for you, and so I did it.
It was very, very nice to work with him. He's very organized and very down to earth, and he had like a really, really good plan what he wanted to achieve with his curation. He was a real team player. He was really trying to make his curation part of Roadburn. Normally the curation stands out and it's like an entity on its own in the festival. Jake was completely like trying to make sure that his picks and his curated part of the entire festival.
Basically, I came up with a dream list of artists that I felt that would be a wonderful fit for the festival, along with Nate, our bass player actually of Converge, because he's also an avid music fan. So we just kind of started tossing ideas back and forth. Eventually we gave the list to Walter and we started working on those things. I started sending a lot of emails and making a lot of calls. A lot of them went unreturned. Some didn't, you know. And you just work really hard and you hope that something can come together.
Not only does Walter have his thumb on what's going on in the metal scene, but he invites people, other respected people, to come in and kind of have their say. And I think that's a really special thing. You know, you're left with a festival where there are no boring sets. If you've seen Converge or Crowbar 100 times, you'll still want to go see them because they're going to go play a landmark album in its entirety. You know, and it might be the only time that they've ever done it in their career.
The whole atmosphere is basically you can walk anywhere and get into any place and see a band that most likely you're going to like, or at least discover something new.
I think it's a festival of discovery. You know, you come in to see bands that you love, but then you discover like dozens of other bands and genres and all kinds of like approaches to music that you didn't even know existed. And I think that's the most addictive thing, you know, if you love music.
The biggest challenge is keeping an interesting lineup year after year, a lineup that is not only like appealing, but also reflects the scene at that time. But I'm also trying to actually put emphasis on what's actually going on. I want to pay tribute to the bands that have played such a great part in this scene, but also I want to have the forward-thinking bands and I want to have the bands that are really trying to outdo themselves musically and artistically. It's a good feeling, but it's very difficult to find that it's the right band at the right time.
Doing a older album, like the You Fail Me album, was really special. I actually felt more connected to that than I did the Jane Doe album, because the Jane Doe album, though it is connected with a lot of people, and I'm really appreciative of that, the You Fail Me album, I consider the beginning of the modern era of our band, and that modern era isn't like 2 years old, it's like 20 years old, you know, or close to that. You know, we started writing those songs in like 2000, so, you know, that's pretty much a big part of our lives as a band, you know. That was a long, arduous creative process for us, and there was a lot going on, and we were working really hard, and the four of us really bonded at the time, and so the album is just really special to us because of that.
The way the town embraces the festival, you know, just you get a warm welcome here. You kind of, everything's incorporated. Like every restaurant has a Roadburn special. Every hotel like has a sign that says "Welcome to Roadburn." I don't think I've ever been to a place that has such a welcoming just vibe for metalheads. You know, you're with family.
I think it's become a part of the town, like their culture. I think the city's helping them too, which makes sense.
You walk outside of the venue and you're in smack in the middle of like the city center of Tilburg, where it's laid back, you can sit down, have something to eat, meet all these people from all over the world just in the adjoining street.
Tilburg is a really special city. The fact that they open up and are so welcoming to heavy music, and that's just a rare thing. Typically when there's a festival, like, not like this, but a heavy festival, it's in a farm field somewhere, like 2 hours, 3 hours away from everything, you know. It's just like, and it's set up specifically for that. That's all well and good, but the fact that the sort of nuts and bolts of the city really embrace it is a beautiful thing.
I mean, at this point, I trust the guys that are putting the festival together. I don't even need to wait until they announce the bands. I'm probably booking the hotel right now.
Nothing better. I'm touring a lot, but for me, it's nothing to compare.
There's a certain energy to the festival where everybody is here to find something new and to find something that really speaks to them. You know, to find the next great band, to find their favorite band that they've always been missing.
I really hope that the festival will contribute to their growth as a quote as an artist. That the festival will play a small part in their musical journey. That the festival will be this hub where they can return like another day to show how much they have grown as a musician, or what they have been doing over the last couple of years, and present it once more to this community that has been so supportive and the community that admires these bands and artists so much. That value, that's basically what I'm looking for. I'm looking for bands that want to come to Roadburn and want to give it all and just benefit from it.